Hey everybody, Invisible Katana here doing my first Let's Play ever, and I'm actually doing it with Assassin's Creed Rogue. The reason I'm starting the video out on this loading screen is actually so that I can kind of put some of my, I guess, Let's Play, isms out there. I don't know what to really call them. But to let you guys know some of the stuff I'm going to be doing with my Let's Plays. The first thing, of course, thank you guys for watching this. I don't know if you came because it's my first Let's Play ever, or if you're a subscriber. Either way, thanks for checking this video out. But the first thing you're gonna notice is that my episodes are gonna be half an hour, and even though I'm like brand new at this, the reason I'm doing that is because I watch a lot of other Let's Players. Odds are if you're here, you watch other Let's Players as well. And they do episodes that are sometimes like 15 minutes or so, and that kind of sucks, especially when it's a game like Assassin's Creed or any like super long game, and it's not something that is being played online. It's kind of like you need the half an hour episodes, and I didn't want to do a full hour because, with me being brand new, I didn't want it to be like an hour's worth of crappiness. So I figured half an hour would be a good place to start because it would be a good amount of time if you are actually interested and entertained by all the crazy crap I'm going to be doing. And it won't be super short, and it'll kind of be a nice balance between 15 minutes and hour long episodes, because it would take a million episodes to go through something like Assassin's Creed, especially because I'm gonna go through the game like I normally would. Like this, for some Let's Players, they kind of shoot through things and it's like, here's the story for everyone, but I'm gonna play the game like I normally would. So if you want, admittedly, a more direct version of the game or a more direct playthrough, you should probably go to someone else, and that you probably already have if you're checking this out, because it's a fairly old game. It's the most recent one I have, but it's Assassin's Creed Rogue. I personally love it. I know, once again, it's one of those big things where Assassin's Creed comes out every year, but I love the game. I got this on Black Friday. It was like I've been waiting to play this, so I wanted it to be my first, official playthrough game, so I'm finally able to make that happen. I have like Liberation on Steam, I have Freedom Cry on Steam. I haven't been able to beat those yet, so I'll probably end up doing playthroughs of those as well. But I, just wanted to get this in, and hopefully I'll be doing the other Assassin's Creed games and kind of just playing them all at the same time, especially considering one of the characters, Ada Dwale, who is from the Freedom Cry DLC, is actually in this game as the older version of him, which is kind of why I really wanted to play Freedom Cry before I ended up playing this. But I highly doubt it'll matter too much. Plus, this would be like the main story that's like just DLC, so it won't have like the real world stuff, I don't think, at least. But this has the main story to it. It's technically, this one comes before Unity, so if you get in the Assassin's Creed games and you haven't gotten them yet, get this one first and then get Unity if you're fortunate enough to even be able to do that. I don't have a Xbox One or PS4 yet, but I'm definitely excited. I'm probably gonna cut here because this is, typical Assassin's Creed. Like the first load up is the slowest thing ever, so I'm actually just gonna cut here, and once things, actually pick up and I'm able to get into the game again, then we'll, keep going from there. All right, so I'm back. As you can see, the lighting's a little bit different. Another little thing I should note, I don't have my own setup, so I'm gonna be all over the place as far as backgrounds. It'll be all sorts of crazy setups. Sometimes a video look like this, where it's just like my head mostly. Sometimes I might actually be in my room and you'll see like me, like all of me sitting on my bed. So that's just another little thing. And sorry about the lighting in the last part too.
Stay my blade from the flesh of the
I
innocent.
also won't be talking too much during the
Hide in
scenes,
plain sight.
because of course I want to see. I want to
Never compromise the Assassin
see
Brotherhood.
exactly what's happening.
These are the tenets of the creed.
Which I guess kind of beats the
the
point
principles
of
I used to live by.
doing a Let's Play. This is shutting up.
I was a young man then. The 7 Years' War was about to begin.
I like how it looks for sure.
I could not have imagined what the future had in store for me. Nor the cost I would choose to bear.
I don't know. I wonder if people are excited
My name
about this
is
kind of
Patrick
going back
Cormac.
to, Assassin's
This
Creed 3
is
style.
my story.
Like, it has like a good and bad to it. Oh, that was fast. All right, well, let's get going. I should already know how to do all these buttons, but I forget sometimes. But like, I wonder how people feel about it going back, because I know like 3 was like the new big thing when it first came out, and it's like, oh man, Assassin's Creed 3. I'm not even paying attention where this guy
Well,
is.
no long lack for firewood at least.
Admit it, I nearly had you.
Nearly counts for nothing, Shay. And besides, no. That was just luck. Mm-hmm.
I make my own luck, Liam.
Ah, you've been saying that for years, but you're precious little to show for it.
Or that's always like a TV thing where trouble. It's like, you don't know this character, so I want to, for whatever reason, just be like, say my sentence, comma, your name. And then, you know their names. I always find that kind of funny when I'm watching TV. It's like, what are you doing, John?
Come on. Like, Captain Deliver André and his crew must have run into some trouble. Who knew meeting with smugglers would lead to no good?
Like I was saying with the Assassin's Creed 3 thing, though, I wonder how many people are actually excited about it going back. Not to tell
you. I thought we were friends, Liam.
It's like OCD already. Assassin's Creed 3. I'm wondering how many people are excited that it went back to the era, because 3 disappointed a bunch of people. What's he doing? I don't know why I just looked up.
Am I going too fast for you?
I'm just keeping an eye on you. In case you fall down and hurt yourself.
Don't know how many people are excited for it to go back, because it has a good and bad to it. Like, it goes back to a location that we've already seen somewhat, because it has the added sea parts. And then it's like, the good side of that is that this becomes like the hub for a lot of assassins, which is how we run into Connor again, and his father, and Adedwale from Assassin's Creed 4, so I think it's actually really, really cool, and I'm really big on story, so it's like, as long as you can make the location cool story-wise, it could be the same place in 5 games. You'd have to be amazing to do that for, you know, a video game. Like a movie, it's way easier to do that, but you know, for a video game, it's a little bit different.
Where the hell were you two?
We're out hunting. What happened here?
My men were attacked by some English sea dogs.
Why, Captain Joseph, couldn't you fight them all off by yourself like you're always saying?
I love his face.
It is Capitaine Louis-Joseph Gautier, Chevalier de la Vérendrye. And you are dreaming if you think any training could make you into a proper assassin. Do you even know what that means? It means being responsible for an ancient and proud tradition. It means obeying your mentor without question.
I don't know.
How else will we ensure freedom for the human race?
Them's pretty words, Chevalier. But I don't feel too free at the moment.
Well then, feel educated! How dare you show me such disrespect?
Also, sorry about the buttons if they're super loud. Still learning.
You irresponsible wretch.
What am I doing? I'm doing the same thing, that's what I'm doing.
You simpleton! You rot-brained cabbage farmer!
I love old-timey insults.
Gentlemen, stop!
Ne'er-do-wells.
We got a common enemy, and I reckon he's close.
The Royal Navy attack my vessel and force my men to flee! We are stranded, and what is worse, the smugglers we were supposed to meet have been taken prisoner! Mm.
Shay and I'll free those smugglers. You treat your wounded.
A lot of awkward silences, it seems. And that's mostly because I'm not saying anything, even though I should.
You'll need them.
That's not bad. I have DLC that I got when I bought the game, but I can't use it because right now I'm filming.
Tread with care, Shay. The Royal Navy be ready
during
for
the
us.
Time of the PSN training. Being hacked, so
ready to teach him a lesson.
They don't stand a chance.
Where are your mates now, you
I can't use whatever the DLC is. Even if I could, I'm sure I wouldn't be able to just instantly get it. And I'm gonna take all this stuff off, because every time I play this game, I hate having everything on there for the HUD. And I wish like, I always want to keep everything off, but I can never get through the game if I leave the map off. Like, I've tried it before. I think the first 2 games, I used to do that, and then I gave up. I was just like, I can't do it anymore. I'm just gonna go crazy. It's like...
Oh.
fairly normal, I guess.
Many thanks.
And rescued.
I thought I'd be hanged.
Sink that French vessel.
Easy. I'm so glad they made that super short compared to like the other Assassin's Creed games, because when they introduced that, I think it was introduced in 2. When they did that in 2, and you had to like do all this extra stuff, it was like hold the button down and then the little meter comes up. Because Assassin's Creed is, of course, it's easy. But they do all the stuff. I just had to pause for a second for how incredibly simple that was. But when they had the stuff, and like even pickpocketing people, they had like the little circle and stuff, and they streamlined those things, and that's always really cool. It's minor stuff, but it's cool. And like the treasure chest, you don't have to bend down, and he's like this feeling on it, trying to get the treasure out. He just, boom, you kick it open. It's nice and simple. I always love the cutscenes when they do action cutscenes, because they do cool stuff that you can do in the game, but I made the way that kind of sucks, so I can't. Like, I'm sure some of you guys have experienced that as well.
Useless. Those blockheads won't be needed in this vessel anymore.
This pile of mail.
A nice streamlined way to get your ship.
You want her, Shay? She is yours. Now bring me back to my ship.
That was nice. That was nice, and that was a perfect streamline for the game. Just like, here we go. Shay. Done.
One. Take the wheel. Some of the men you rescued agreed to join us. They should prove a good crew.
I'm not so certain about their captain, but next to me, you are the most experienced sailor in the Brotherhood, Shay. Besides, we could use another vessel. Given this pitiful
lot. She's mine, ain't she?
Fire right into a mouth. Sink us like the Titanic.
Your own pile of garbage, yes?
With a lick of paint and a few new cannons, she'll look as fine as anything on the Seven Seas.
Shall we begin, Captain?
Indeed, mate.
I feel really weird being thrown into
she's
this.
She's a mess.
One because,
but she's still afloat.
Like in the last
and her
game.
Name's the bargain.
Rogan!
That's pretty cool.
Silly fairy queen of
and
Maryland,
actually causes
device?
Realistic waves,
oh,
too.
Oh, she's perfect for you, Shay.
Margaret was an old goddess.
Like I was saying, I feel...
Queen of war and darkness. She halves of the souls of fallen
really
warriors.
Paying any attention to anything.
Perfect indeed.
I feel a little weird being kind of thrown
ship.
In.
They will sink her!
Let's put the Margaret to the test, Captain Shay.
Ready for
end
battle,
of the
man.
Last game. Like some crazy stuff happened, and it's always like that, you kind of just poof, you toss right in, and that's kind of the new thing that they do now, where it's much, much more inside the Animus than outside the Animus, but it starts to feel a little weird not being in the real world, I guess, and just being tossed right into the story.
Do something!
I also feel incredibly weird not having my side cannons straight from the beginning. It was very unnatural, even though it's been a while since I even played 4. I feel very unnatural. I do have a... Wow. I'm just... really stupid, that's all. This thing's about to go down. I'm about to lose already. I do like that though. The cinematic view is pretty nice. The being thrown in, as you can't already tell, I get incredibly distracted.
This vessel is battle ready off the road.
I just jump all over topics. I just like that in general. So it might take me forever to eventually get to the point. Sorry if that bothers you. I will try to streamline that, just like they streamline stuff in the game. But that's just me. Like that probably won't change, unfortunately. And it's just how I am. So I'm going to see something. Oh, I love this song. So I just stop. Like, I love this song. And then I just stop. Like, the thoughts just fly in and then they fly off because something else comes to my attention.
What course would you have me set, Shay?
Time to report back to the mentor. Wouldn't you agree?
Wise words, Captain.
So, like, I feel like this would be the perfect point to take me out of the Animus, and then I get introduced to the real world component of the game. And I believe in this one, they kind of take the, I guess, the real life portion far down. Oh, see, they did do it. I believe they took it down way more than they did even in the last one. And I think Unity goes beyond even this.
Some kind of dormant virus? Shit. Hang on, I'm getting you out of there.
I always love that. I think it was since maybe Brotherhood. Every time you're in there, it's always different.
Sorry, I thought that was pretty cool. He's working, check.
Just like the symbols for the,
Animus, yes?
I'm a different person? Oh, man.
You were using it to access a genetic memory file in Helix labeled Shay Cormac? You work for Abstergo Entertainment, remember? Any of this ringing a bell? Your session triggered something bad, and it's affecting the whole building. We need to find your boss.
Okay.
You haven't forgotten your boss, have you? Melanie LeMay, sipper, chipper, overachiever? Here, take your communicator.
This makes it even weirder, because... Now, I'm not even the same person. I'm not even the same random person I was.
What's double this? Time.
Rising
this
Phoenix.
This chaos is absolutely your fault, in case you're wondering.
Oh, see, I believe that's... Yeah, that's out of Dwale. That is Eveline from Liberation. So that's kind of cool. And I'm sure I'll get some more statues. Far Cry. I thought that was pretty cool in the last game.
Come with me if you want to live.
That's also cool because that's from Terminator. And I love Terminator. Okay. Well, she dropped Terminator on me, so I gotta go.
Come on, everyone. Just like we practiced in our safety drills. Everything is gonna be okay, guys. Stay
move
positive.
Fast. Here we go. This is definitely weird to me.
A file labeled Shay Cormac was booby-trapped with some kind of virus.
Your job is to prevent things like this.
We need to contain these genetic memories, then we can destroy them.
No. Isolate them. I want to study these memories.
But...
With respect, Miss LeMay, this is not a request.
You heard the man.
Like,
fine.
Just all thrown off now.
I need to borrow your numbskull.
Like,
that okay with you, Ms. LeMay?
I was...
Hey there, this might seem a bit weird, but you're gonna work for contractors we hired to, you know, upgrade our security. Mr. Otsoberg and Ms. Violet DaCosta.
Call me Violet.
I have to go check on our people and prepare a statement for the
bus. So I was a random person
last time. Do whatever they tell you to do, okay?
No, I'm a new random person.
Go team!
This time. Go team. And so, that just makes it really weird to me.
You're the one who let the virus out, so I think it's only fair to help clean it up.
Huh.
Mr. Berg wants us to relive Shay's genetic memories.
Silent characters. I'm gonna walk away from her. Who's this guy? I thought he was a statue of an assassin, honestly. Whoa. Why'd that scare me?
Design this virus is a genius. Not only does it restrict our access to the cloud,
alright. Alright, I know I said that I would do everything like I normally do, but I'm not gonna bother you guys with the reading portion, which admittedly I also stopped doing that after I think I stopped doing that after like maybe Revelations. I was like, all right, I just can't. Every building I want to know the history of it. I want to know everything here and there, and I just
there's a working area server on this floor. I guess it'll have to do for now.
I know I've also been talking a lot through a lot of these scenes
since they're not cutscenes.
Why? He's just a nobody as far as I can tell.
Shay Cormac is who I suspect he is, then this temporary setback may provide us with an unexpected reward.
No.
Proceed to the server room on the floor.
Just gonna get in her way. Looks like it just went nuts in here. Like, a little bit. It's like, it's just a little disheveled. Like, oh no, these boxes and these random papers are on the floor. Mass hysteria. Like, everyone's freaking out, and it's just like... perfect little itty-bitty increments where it's just like, oh no, these papers, I had to for some reason fly from across that chair to the other end of my desk and just do this and knock all my stuff over. So this is funny, like the little bits of bits and pieces that are messed up.
Better trained than you are.
Jeez, she's mean. She's a meanie. See, now I have a bunch of questions, because, like I said, in the last one, I was a random person, which was fine. That was the new thing after Desmond died. It made perfect sense. It wasn't too weird. But now I'm a second random person, And it just makes it really weird to me. Like, how do I run into the other person? Would it matter? Because technically you don't even see what you look like in the old game. There's Far Cry again.
Come on,
And her, she's making me mad. And I don't know why. It's just making me mad. It's super simple.
Do you see a flashing wireless signal? Great. Mm-hmm. That means you can still access systems. Go ahead and patch me into their feed. Once you restore the server, I'll connect your Animus workstation back to Helix. In theory, if you align the beams to segments of the core, it should solve the problem. But here's where it gets tricky. You have to move the circles in such a way that each segment is powered by a beam. Mm-hmm. The keyword here is each. One beam and one beam only per core segment, okay?
Okay.
Once everything is lit up properly, the system will reboot. Got it? Give it a shot.
I didn't get a single bit of that, actually.
Good job. This core wasn't too complex.
Yeah, I'm probably going to be skipping those in the future, just to be honest. Like, the puzzles, the puzzle in the last, and there is one.
The assassins would have you believe that Al-Mu'allim was a great mentor who became corrupted with greed, and that he schemed with the Templars to acquire an Apple of Eden. I see instead a shrewd and cunning leader. A man who used his best assassin, Altair ibn Lahad, to eliminate his conspirators in order to keep the apple for himself, so that he could use it.
I miss those little glitches.
While it must be stated unequivocally that Al-Mu'allim was not a Templar, it is interesting to me that his vision of peace was more in line with Templar philosophy than assassin. In the past, both sides had the same goal. That of peace. Our only difference was how we chose to achieve it. Had Al-Mu'allim not been killed by Altair and allowed to carry out his plan, perhaps we would not be fighting now.
Interesting.
It was only after Altair reformed the Brotherhood with its new ideals of free will that the conflict truly escalated and spread across the planet. For if the so-called wise man of the mountain can see things from our point of view, surely the same can be said for other assassins.
Interesting. And this is another component that I'm very excited about in this game.
You're supposed to be back. Just,
pirates.
You should just get back to your Animus.
Chairs.
Is that asteroid? Whenever back online, you could, in theory, restore your co-workers' workstations if you, you know, feel like being helpful. And you could, in theory, find some more digital goodies if you, you know, be like being sneaky.
Okay, see, now I have to wonder if she's like secretly with the
If you see any tech lying around like that, grab them. There might be a clue what you did this.
I'm wondering if she might secretly be.
We stand on the brink of a grand discovery.
Okay.
I know you must have questions about your new assignment, or about me. For
I
now,
think this is the guy from the last game.
All I will say is that Shay's story contains the answers. Shay will lead you to a greater understanding.
See? Oh no! Knock out the second fire extinguisher. Okay. I'm wondering if these secret contractors may or may not be working with the assassins.
You know what authorized personnel only means, don't you?
I can't zoom in. I don't know. I bothered. I kind of doubt they're working with the assassins, but you never really know in this game. Like, there are only two people that are officially with the assassins because they're actually.
But I might be a terrible person.
Because actually, in the last game, I think she's just like, I hate these people. I hate, you know, the woman who's the leader. Like, too perky for her or something, and she just wants to get her job done and keep on moving. So. Yeah, I doubt they're working with the assassins or, you know, have any real dog in this fight, but, oh, that's cool. Little Connor, or, not Connor, Edward Kenway, pizza. Oh, like a little, that's cool, little Nerf gun. Alright, so I'm just gonna get back to it, go and get back in the Animus, because that's more entertaining than watching me walk around these offices and stuff. And admittedly, like I said, I'm gonna play it the way I normally would, but there will be moments like this where it's like, I'd probably walk around a little more. Probably not, because honestly, you can't go anywhere, which, you know, you're level one. I'm sure at some point I'll be hacking once again, and I'll be going all over the place. For whatever reason, I'll get more, you know, random access to this, that door for who knows what reason. But, you know, I will do this, though, just to try to make sure I do understand these puzzles a little bit better. Okay. Oh, okay. I see. Okay, I don't think I'm understanding it the way I thought I did. I do understand it better now. The little gold piece adding to the difficulty kind of threw me off for a second. I thought it just meant that messed up the signal, so it didn't count. But now I understand.
Hey, boss. Calling from Germany?
Yes. I am in Essen, searching for an artifact called the Ankh of Isis. Can you tell me anything about it?
Give me a minute to fire up my machines here. Okay. Not much. There's an obscure file from the data dump scanner that mentions it. It was allegedly 14th century Germany, where an assassin named Lucas Zurgberg fought a Templar offshoot called the Brothers of the Cross. How original.
Zurgberg. That's the file that might, I think that's why I just laughed. I'm like, why does it sound so funny to me?
Is there anything else? Also, anything outside of Abstergo official records?
Sounds kind of funny to me.
Nobody's ever seen the thing.
Sorry.
If there's all kinds of stories about its history.
But if your name rhymes.
Roman Gallia, Egypt during the Middle Ages, and even a cell of modern-day assassins. Oh. And it apparently raises the dead.
Is there any evidence to support this?
None at all. You know what I think?
Assassins.
I think this is bullshit the assassins are spreading around so that people like us waste our valuable time sniffing after it. Smells like a trap.
Agreed. Keep an eye out for new information about the Ankh. While it may not lead to an artifact, we may be able to follow the data back to some assassins.
You got it, boss. Where are you off to next?
Cuba. I'm going to excavate the observatory.
Oh. Okay, see, stuff like this is kind of what I really like about this new, I guess, storytelling style of the games, where you play a random person who just so happens to be, like, the person who gets to walk around and explore all this random stuff. You get to kind of get a feel for the Templars as Abstergo, and I always thought that was kind of cool. Like, them, especially in the last game when it was introduced in 4, it's like, we're Abstergo now, and we're, like, a movie-making company, and it's not just Abstergo's the people, you know, that are kind of trying to kill us off.
This is a restricted area.
Okay. I'm gonna go back to my desk, but I think it's one of the, it's one of the cool elements to the new form of them telling the story. It's like, you go around, you find stuff, it's like, okay, you can tell, like, based on the dialogue from that, some people are a little bit higher in the chain, and you can tell they know far more about the Templar versus Assassin War compared to probably this character and the last character that you play as in Assassin's Creed 4. It's just like, just, you know, we're just random characters who got hired to, you know, go in and try to make movies and stuff. It was kind of funny to listen to people say certain terms and, you know, hear their dialogue. It's like, okay, they know this, and then this other person's a little bit lower.
It has been a long time.
Oh, that was fast.
Achilles.
Adewale. How go things in the West Indies?
Very poorly, I'm afraid.
Ooh.
Your countenance tells me we should discuss this. Come.
Who's our visitor?
Atarawale, who's a slave who freed himself, and hundreds of his brothers in the West Indies. That man's a living incarnation of the Creed.
I see.
Cool.
You join me for some practice?
Soon. I've got other business first.
That's another reason I really want to play Freedom Cry, because as much as, like, I love Assassin's Creed 4, I'm just going to stick on that.
The ground shook, and the ocean waves crashed over Port-au-Prince.
How many were lost?
Thousands. No family was left untouched.
I hate to bring up practical matters, but did my father's man complete his task for the
earthquake? I cannot know.
Just checking to see if I have, like, all the normal stuff, like two blades, one blade, if you have to gain two.
Such a shame. Like that. So we cannot know if he found the site.
Indeed. But if there was a temple on the
making others wait for you as usual? Standing.
And the artifacts that showed the way?
Stolen. The Templars broke in during the chaos. They seized the manuscript and precursor box.
I was going to stand here and made a legend. Chiefs on the sea, but lost their trail
when they reached New York.
We must consider what to do next.
Sup. Okay. Nope, invisible wall. So, I was actually.
I heard that Liam's waiting for you. Seen him yet?
Oh, he's talking to me. Okay. So, when I first heard about Rogue, when it was like you run into this character and that character, I didn't know it took place so much earlier than 3. I thought it was actually maybe like a little bit before 3, or at least even during the time of 3. Actually, I didn't know it was like years before, because Achilles, if you haven't played 3, Achilles is like really old in that game, and he's like super young, and it was like, oh, I didn't know it was this early. So it's actually kind of cool. And you know, that's the same house, so this is one of those things where it's like I said, if you have the same location, it's actually pretty cool. Like, if you story-wise, if you can make it work for me, then hey, that I appreciate that. It makes it a little bit better. I'm actually hitting, well, I think I already passed the 30-minute mark, so I'm actually going to end this first episode here. Thanks for checking it out. I know I didn't really do anything remotely entertaining in this one, and of course, with this being the first video, I need a ton of feedback, so I know, you know, like, was am I too close to the mic with my controller, sound, lighting, all this and that, everything. I need you guys to give me some feedback. I really appreciate you checking this out, like I said. Please join me in the next part.